Welcome back to Donkey Kong Country 2 with me, Matthew Caddis, aka Puggy. So, we are going to revisit some of the levels we've kind of missed thus far in the game. Starting with Parachute Panic. Again, we kind of did this in the last episode, but I am actually missing the DK coin, which is right at the beginning. Seriously. The DK coin is at the very beginning of the stage. And it's easy to miss because I did not use Dixie's helicopter twirl here, which, honestly, I really should have done. But there you go. And let's see. What other things did I miss? Well, I'm having Quarks carry me down. And then we have a hidden area there. Yeah, basically you have to carry the thing right down there. And there is a rare symbol as well, which I do like. So yes, a little shortcut here. And indeed, right down here to the bottom will take us, hopefully, to just another banana coin, apparently. Well, that seems to be part of the course with my adventures in these honey levels. And what do we have here? Two claptraps. We've already seen this stuff. And yeah. But there you go. But there is a secret area off to the right. Well, not there, but of two claptraps near the beginning, just after you get the DK coin. Now, I want to actually aim towards the left here, so I'm hugging the roof rather than the wall. And that's not going to be easy with Quarks, because given how he functions in game, seriously. So if I fail this time, I'm just going to skip ahead to when I do so, because otherwise it's just going to be a rather messy episode, if you know what I mean. It is certainly going to be messy otherwise. I'll go back to when I do it right then. Okay, maybe I didn't have to. Now this area with the sticky things we do need to get up to in order to get to the second bonus barrel here. So indeed, yeah, the second bonus stage, should I say, which involves the much better Squawks the Parrot. Oh yes, so indeed, let's get to it. And it's a good thing we are using Squawks, because there are a bunch of zingers in this room. With Squawks, it isn't too bad. Nope, it's actually quite fun. So yeah, and after that, well, we have a TNT barrel, which we can fling at this one. And that's that! Yeah, not too bad at all. So on to the, I think the next area. We've already seen this bit with Quarks, so where to next, I say? Okay, no, I am not going to do that. Indeed, to find this bonus stage in Web Woods, what you have to do is get a crow, not a crow, a cannon to shoot his cannonball at the thing. And yeah, and this one is all Squitter, seriously. Which is fine with me, because I love Squitter the Spider. Basically, this is not a destroy them all sort of scenario. No, it's not. Basically, what you have to do is find the token. So yeah. And avoid the brambles. Yep, it's another one of those levels. But, as I say, nothing too hard so long as you know how to platform with Squitter, which I do. Easily one of my favorite animal buddy. So, yeah. And with that, I think we'll move on to the boss. Creepy Crow. And he is pretty tough. Although, I did skip yet another bonus stage here, which I do want to. Near the area with the diving critters, where we want to go again is to use this cannon with a K to access another area. Seriously. So, because that wall of bananas was showing us where to go, yeah. And this time it's collecting the stars. In this time, in the form of the Rareware symbol, which I absolutely love, because I loved Rareware's games back in the 90s, and don't you dare fall off there, Squitter. Seriously. And so, yeah, I must have missed that one as well. So, what about the boss, Creepy Crow? Well, let's see. This one's an interesting boss, because Unlike before, we are actually having to do quite a bit of platforming in order to actually damage him. So, yeah. Firstly, you will have to deal with a bunch of Neki Juniors and damage him. That's another thing. Creepy Crow is perhaps worse for the fact that you have to hit him with the barrel, and that's not easy. But, yeah. He won't stick around, basically, unlike some of the other bosses. What he will do instead is rattle his own nest, sending down a bunch of his own eggs and whatnot, while having to deal with, when you get to the top, I think more of the, ouch, I hate those eggs. Seriously, figuring out the pattern is very, very tough. So a very worthy opponent, then, is Creepy Crow. Seriously. Because all you hear is the eggs falling, the oof sort of noise. And when I'm, and that's another thing, I stick around on like one of the things until you hear the falling noise, and then, yeah, then you jump to the thing. There is more than one DK barrel, so yeah, I'm not sure if I want to lose a thing, but there you go. So yeah, as for the Neki Juniors, most of them are ghosts, except for one. And that the last Neki Jr. that will appear that isn't a ghost, you do have to actually jump on his head. So yeah, and that will bring up another barrel. And you can actually damage Creepy Crow before he actually comes down, which is definitely a blessing. So yeah. And then now the eggs will come from all over, seriously. And poor Diddy! Poor Diddy, he fell to his death. Yeah, that is not what I wanted to happen, so let's try that again. So, yep, okay, so I would have avoided, I wouldn't, oh no, I can't even speak. So yeah, I died. Okay, head to the left, then, do I want to jump off? No, because there's no DK barrel there. So keep moving, and then jump up there to the very top of the thing. So, more Neki Juniors again, so I don't want to wait out again for the one that is... well, dare I even say alive, jump over the last two ghost ones, and then hit Creepy Crow right in the kisser, and he explodes into a million pieces, and we get our, creme coin. So, yeah. So, on the next episode, I think we'll, go to Kirul's Keep, but I'm not sure. But I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye! And then this time I do mean for real.